In this episode of the Under Attack Show, we tour with a kitsch skateboard team on Vancouver Island, and then we take a behind-the-scenes look at DC Portage Tour. During the summer, Kitsch Skateboards assembled their team and traveled to all the skate parks on Vancouver Island. There's still more to come on the Under Attack Show.
I'm Swell, and this is behind the scenes of the DC Portage video, and everything you wanted to know that you didn't get to see, you might get a little sneak peek.
Let us know that the good time go, let the good time go.
The DC Portage Tour is where Sean Hayes got the DC team together and we did a trip across Canada to make a promo video for SBC and have an article in SBC, and it's a really fun trip.
Being in the van was cool, but it was really uncomfortable for like long trips. It was kind of neat because we had we just had like two back seats. Like the back was just like all of our luggage, and so and then like two people would just lie on the luggage or whatever. So it was pretty cool because you like sleep up there. Cancel the thing that I said I do. I don't feel comfortable talking to you. That shit got to zip up, fixed on my shoes, and I'll be in the lobby drinking for two.
Basically, there's no rails out here to skate big enough for us, so we had to just go jump in the ocean, which is equivalent to about like 30 stair, because probably minus a trillion. Feeling all right. Kind of might have lost a couple pounds. Some of us might have vaginas now. But yeah, about it. I hate the way you talk your Japanese skin. It's been too many years of truth.
I think for him to be on the tour across Canada, it must have been a little sketchy at first, you know, like a bunch of dudes that he's never really hung around with, you know, like all of a sudden just thrown into a van and next thing you know, they're wedging him and, you know, like... The really cool part about Sean Hayes driving is he was down for whatever. If you wanted to stop, he'd stop. If you wanted to go swimming in that lake over there, he'd stop for you to go swim in the lake. If you needed a shit, he'd stop for you to shit, like... He was pretty much down for the cause, and he was definitely pushing everyone. And if like he wasn't pushing everyone, he was the one skating the freaking thing, and everyone's like, you know, the team manager is the one kicking our ass, you know, like, let's get it going. So yeah, he definitely got everyone off their ass. He inspired everyone to just pretty much be their best and have the most fun they could. Star. Some of my favorite moments on the whole trip were like, I don't know, the whole trip was kind of like, at the end of it, blurred into just one big memory of just like, oh my god, that was the best trip I've ever been on in my life, you know?
I love this dark phone, as it is bright lights.
Our pranks were pretty fun though, because, you know, most of them were played to Lil Will because he was like our little bitch. Of his Will fight. And then Will retaliates later on. It's undercover, you don't see this on the film. He pisses in his shoes and Sasha didn't know, and Sasha skated around for like a week or two, so that's pretty nasty. We end up going to check out pro skateboards and snowboards, and they had a little like 2 foot mini like little quarter pipe in there with like masonite ground, so you had a good run up in it. It was really fun, and so we're sitting there, and I like just doing like flatland nose manuals, and out of nowhere I think it was Joel was like, hey, you and AJ should have like a competition so you can go the longest. And AJ was like, yeah. And it started off being like something like $100 or something, and I was like, no, because I didn't know how like his skill level. So I was like, whatever, let's just do. I think it was like $5 or $10 we did it for. And we did a nose man, see who did the longest. And I don't know how long, I probably went for like 5 minutes or something like that. I think they filmed it all. But yeah, I ended up beating AJ, and yeah, so I'm undefeated. So if you got a nose man competition, let's do this. Make money, take money.
Check it!
still more with the DC team after this break.
Oh yeah, yeah, the Kenora skate park was pretty sick. We stopped by there and it wasn't like completely built, but the dude that owned the skate shop, he was like, he told us it'd be cool if we like jumped the fence and skate the park before anybody else got a chance to, so we got to skate there for a few hours, film some stuff. Yeah, then after that, later on that night, we went back to his house and he had like a mini ramp in his backyard, so it was pretty cool. We had some beers and got to skate his ramp, got some tricks, filmed some stuff, it was pretty sick. There are those who fear the deep, but the world don't wait when your faith won't
leave. I know it was only a dream.
London ledge spot, that place was so cool. Like, we just decided one day, we're like, hey, you guys want to skate Toronto for a day? And we're like, sure. And then Chad's like, let's go to London, let's go skate there and have a party. And we're like, okay. And it was the day of the, I believe it was the Stanley Cup. So we're like, yeah, let's do that. So we head out to London and then we get there and it was a little wet. And so we're skating, you know, and then all of a sudden, just torrential downpour, like gnarly. And out of nowhere, like, I believe I was at the car with Paul Trep changing my shoes because they were soaked, and freaking Aaron Johnson's just freaking throwing some shit down, you know, like just hucking shit, and it was really cool, you know, because everyone was kind of bummed, you know, we're just getting flat ground into this undercover area.
Conditions are pretty good. It's a little wet, but I mean, it depends, you know. Speaking of wetness, is your glass half full or half empty? Mine is half full. I'm an optimistic rain skateboarder. Feels good. You don't have to, okay, the consequence of being wet for 8 hours before we get to the hotel, but that's okay. Soggy balls are just a state of mind.
We spent Go Skate Day in Winnipeg, and that was really cool because we went to skate around the town, and we went to that black rail that everyone seems to hook the carcass down.
I love that rail so much. So I just felt like really confident just because it's like a skate park rail, basically. So.
It was cool skating with everyone because you could see they really respected watching the guys, you know. Like, Sassy was hucking down like a demo there, so they were just like, yeah, you know, in awe. I even sat there in awe, like, whoa, Sassy's good shit. Yeah, we met with Crawley. He took us around, showed us all the same spots we've seen in all the videos, you know. And it was really cool because, you know, not every time you get to chill with Crawley, man, you know, it's like, it's always an adventure.
Long-term solution to the notion that everything must go be shown off, be bad.
soon as we got to Calgary, we went to the Millennium Park. Ryan got like this crazy frontside flip over the hip, like nollied over. Me and Sasha skated the big two sets. I think that's the only time I skated in Calgary. I hooked up with a couple chicks there. Try to keep the wheels steady now, easy as she goes. I can hear all the wind, a tale that needs to be told again. The horizon bends at either end, and the sea can't tell a foe from a friend.
Thank you very much, DC. Thank you very much, Sean Hayes. That was like, oh my god, like, words can't explain the trips and things we did, you know, like, it was good shit, and I'd definitely do that again, so.
Thanks for watching this episode of the Nerd Attack Show. In the next episode, we go to Vancouver for the Lord of the Lions contest in the Summer Ends Gym. To own this show and other videos on DVD, order online at underworldshop.com. If you'd like to know more about the music in our shows, or want to know what's going on, check out our website at underattacktour.com.